You're now tuned in to the Real Money Coach broadcast with host Tony Jackson, author of the book Increase, Protect, and Dominate Your Money. Get ready for winning tips and strategies to effectively manage your finances and learn the key principles of protecting and dominating your money. Now, here's author and host Tony Jackson.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good morning, good morning, good morning. You are listening to the Real Money Coach Show here on 100.9 Praise Charlotte, right? Charlotte's inspiration station. And as I remind you each and every week, every place that you get your podcast. I'm so thrilled and so honored to really just, being part of your day and you listening to me, whether you're doing it on early this Saturday morning or you're listening to one of the podcasts. I just don't take it for granted that you're tuning in. And so I just want to just before we even get started, just say thank you for doing that. Today's show, I'm really kind of dedicating it to really cancer victims and also maybe critical illness and that type of thing. And so I have a wonderful interview with a young lady. Her name is Jade Smith. You hear her after we take a musical break here in a few minutes. But she is just a sophomore in high school. She goes to Charlotte Lab School. She is the daughter of Marlon Smith, which you guys know Marlon and I are business partners. We do a lot of business together, a lot of speaking together, and all those types of great things. So, matter of fact, last weekend we were up at North Carolina A&T University speaking to students a week ago. And what a fabulous time. I just enjoyed being with all the college students, their energy. And I was so pleasantly surprised with their engagement and the financial stuff that I was talking about. And so that was really, really exciting. You've probably seen a few clips on Facebook Reels or on IG of my talk there. So but had a great time. But Jade is just a sophomore in high school, and she is a team leader on a fundraising project for cancer research and the like. Now, I have to admit that when she approached me or asked me about it, I was really kind of instantly said, yes, I will help. Because they're talking about blood cancers and that type of thing. And my dad actually passed from leukemia. And, it's such, I remember it quite well when he was diagnosed. He was diagnosed and it was like on a Good Friday, actually. So it was, getting close to that time of year. And, and I can remember my dad sending everyone out of the room and he told them this. He said, listen, the doctor had put it down like this. The doctor said, listen, you have two choices. You can take chemo. And if you take chemo, you're going to have about a 50% chance of living longer, but the chemo is going to be very hard on you. Or you can choose not to take chemo. You may not live as long, but the quality of your days will probably be better. So my dad sends everyone out of the room. And I'm left in the room and he says to me, son, you got to get ready. You got to get them prepared for me to go because I'm not taking chemo. His words were, I'm 86 years old. I know where I'm going. I know where I will spend eternity. So you have to prepare them for my departure. And so the story, so that's what it was. My dad said that was it. And so my dad lived a couple hours away from me in Michigan at the time. And I'd go to my dad's house and you would never know that anything was wrong. You would never know that, that he was sick. I mean, he loved the grandkids. His favorite thing to tell his grandkids would squeeze my neck. When he hugged him, he wanted that tight squeeze. And so, you never knew that he was sick at all. And so he was in and out of the hospital a couple times during this couple months. And so then when We were going to, it was June, right? So my dad's birthday's in April. This all happened around, you know, Good Friday. And so, it was June around my father-in-law's birthday, actually. And we were planning on taking my father-in-law to, breakfast to celebrate his birthday. And my stepmom called me and said, "Hey, your dad's in the hospital." And so I said, "Okay, well, you know, we got plans to take Lisa's dad to breakfast for his birthday in the morning. And then, you know, we'll come there." And so that was a Friday night. And later on that night, you know, it was kind of, you know, around 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock. I just told my wife, you know, I just couldn't really rest. And really, I believe it was Holy Spirit just talking to me. And I said, I'm going tonight. And you and the kids stay, take your dad to breakfast, and then you guys can drive up, you know, afterwards." And so I took off at about 9 o'clock. So about 11 o'clock or so, and I said, "I'm not going to the house. I'll just go straight to the hospital." So I did. I got in my car, took the 2-hour drive, walked into my dad's hospital room, and my dad said to me, "Son, I knew you would come." And those are the last words I remember him saying, "Son, I knew you would come." And then when I eulogized my father after he passed, and I said, the next words I hear my dad say when I get to heaven is, "Son, I knew you'd come." And so because of that experience, when Jade asked me to be involved in this fundraiser that is fighting leukemia, I immediately said, "I'm in." And so that's why we're here today. That's what we're going to talk about. And so we're going to take a quick musical break, and then we're going to come back and going to have this wonderful interview with this young lady, Jade Smith. You're listening to The Real Money Coach Show here on Praise 100.9 and everywhere you listen to your podcast.
Here we are. Let's get on one accord. Leave all your problems on the outside to be consumed with the whole.
Family, join author Tony Jackson for the Real Money Coach broadcast each and every Saturday morning from 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9. Mr. Jackson enlightens you on the real secrets of money. He'll also help you increase, protect, and dominate your money. You can also catch Tony Jackson's The Real Money Coach every Tuesday at 8 p.m. on Facebook Live and YouTube. Check out The Real Money Coach, Mr. Tony Jackson, every Saturday morning, 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9.
Hey, Tony Jackson here. You know me as The Real Money Coach. Listen, I want to encourage you to do something. And what I want to encourage you to do is email me your questions, your comments, or even suggestions that of topics that you'd like us to cover on The Real Money Coach Show. You can email it to info@therealmoneycoach.com. Again, that's info@therealmoneycoach.com. Email us your questions, your comments, your suggestions, and we will answer those on air and also on our Facebook Live YouTube show on Tuesdays at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. So make sure you email us so that we can get that information that you want to know in your ears. I am Tony Jackson, The Real Money Coach.
And welcome back to The Real Money Coach broadcast with author and host, Tony Jackson.
Welcome back to The Real Money Coach Show here on Praise 100.9 and every place you get your podcast. You know, I'm telling y'all that every week because I want you to go to the podcast and tell your friends about the podcast. It's on Apple. It's on Google. It's on, if you maybe a little older, you like Pandora or whatever, wherever you're listening to your podcast, we are there. And so I have a special guest in the studio with me today. Listen, many of you are familiar with Marlon Smith, who's a business partner. He's been on the show before, but I have his daughter, Jade Smith, who's just a sophomore in high school, almost a college, Jade, in high school, in the studio today. And we're going to talk more about, as I mentioned in the early part of the show, you know, we're talking about critical illness in my masterclass, which includes cancer, heart attacks, kidney failures. And we know those things happen in our community. And so Jade is involved in a fundraiser, and I'm going to let her tell you about that in terms of cancer awareness, particularly leukemia, I do believe. So, Jade, how are you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing well. I'm doing well. So, Jade, tell the audience who is listening this morning a little bit about yourself.
Yes, yeah, so I am Jade Smith. I am a sophomore at Charlotte Lab School. It's a local charter school, pretty new, in the heart of downtown Charlotte. I play volleyball, and I am looking into the medical field right now. I want to be a doctor, so this topic specifically is really near and dear to me, something that I'm really passionate about.
Okay, that's awesome. And you know, we believe in being in things that are passionate, and when I first heard about what you're doing in this particular fundraiser, and it's leukemia, correct?
Yes, leukemia, lymphoma, myeloma, any blood cancer specifically.
Okay. And the reason why that was really important to me, because my dad passed of leukemia. And, you know, I just remember going through that process and all of that. So when I heard about you doing this, it just touched a part of my heart because of that. So tell us a little bit about some of the activities that you guys are doing and a little bit about the fundraising effort, period.
Yes. So this year I was nominated by my college counselor for the 2023 Charlotte Student Visionaries of the Year campaign. So basically during this 7-week philanthropic fundraising campaign, I am competing with top students across the country to raise funds and awareness for the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society and their mission of curing blood cancers and hopefully one day all cancer. So I'm leading a multi-generational team, and my hope is to share the work that I'm doing with more of the community and my environment of Charlotte. So the campaign kicked off January 12th, which was my 16th birthday. And
she had to get that in there, y'all. She had to get that.
I was did, 16, I did. Right? That's 16, cool. 16. And then it ends on March 4th, where we'll have our like celebration. And so I'm going into the third week right now, almost fourth. So about halfway mark. So I'm excited. Yeah,
that's pretty cool. And I don't know very many people in our society that have not been touched by someone who has been diagnosed with cancer. And so I think it's very, very, very important that we continue research and those types of things. And I think that's what the fundraising is all about. So do you have a fundraising goal?
Yes, of course. So I, this year I've set a personal fundraising goal of $75,000, for the foundation. And I'm happy to say that I'm about 20% of the way there. So I'm really excited to just see where everything goes. I have a really great team. This is definitely something pretty new for me. I've never done like anything, I guess, for a fundraising competition, but it's for a really good cause, and I hope to just impact a lot of lives and patients.
Well, you know, I think it's a pretty awesome cause to be involved in. Again, you know, I think you talked about, I'm familiar with the leukemia, but Hodgkin's disease and other different, you said blood cancers. So I think that's pretty awesome and says a lot about you that you would want to take this on. And so is there anything, what have you guys done any type of activities and that type of thing to help raise funds?
Yes. So I've done a few things, actually. This campaign not only is helping me personally, but, you know, other people generally, but a few weeks, well, last week, I actually had the opportunity to visit my school's different campuses. So we were able to pass out different flyers to a lot of the parents and just getting more of the lab community of my school involved. We are a really small school, so that's really important to us. And then also I've spoken with a lot of organizations, just getting really more people in the community. Spreading awareness is really big for me. I've really taken like the mission pillar of policy and advocacy. So just spreading awareness and support for just to ensure this generation is the last to see cancer for other teenagers like me.
Wow, that's awesome. Hey, I like that. Make sure this is the last generation that has to deal with cancer. That's an audacious goal, and I love it. But it takes money. It takes funds to do that. So that's pretty dope, actually. There's so much to it, you know. And so now you mentioned that you want to be a doctor.
Yes.
Okay.
I do.
So tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so I've always been interested in science, particularly. I've had the opportunity to do some job shadowing with an OBGYN. That was really what I was looking towards, that specific field. But now I've kind of looked into it. I'm like, I'm not sure if I want to do this. But so I'm getting really more of the hands-on effects. But I really just want to make a difference in patients' lives. I really take a special place in my heart for just everyone's diseases and like what they have to go through, because I've seen the effects of people that I care about personally. And so I just want to make a difference and an impact on those around me. So
that's pretty cool. And you're actually going to be on our show on Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern with your grandmother.
I will.
Who is a cancer survivor herself. And so I think that's going to be a pretty awesome experience, and having the two of you on together. I mean, we're talking multi-generation, right?
Yes.
Your grandma, you get to be on the show with your grandma. And that's, I think that's awesome. So, Jade, if someone, what we're going to do, folks who are listening, is I'm going to post a link to her fundraising page inside of the Real Money Coach Facebook group. So you can go to Real Money Coach Community, join our Facebook group, and there will be a link there directly to Jade's fundraising page. And on Tuesday, obviously, we'll be sharing that on the live show. We'll have the link there in the chat so anyone can support this very, very important mission of, you know, let's knock out cancer. And I think about other blood diseases that kind of, you know, affect us, sickle cell and some of those things that happen to our community. And so I just want to end with this statement. Black girls in STEM rock. Jade Smith, you rocked it today. Thank you for being part of the show. And we look forward to seeing you on Tuesday.
Yes, I look forward to it, too. Thank you so much for having me.
Listen, we're going to take a quick break and we're going to come right back with the Real Money Coach Show. I'll wrap up the show. Going to talk more about things that you can do to help offset the cost of treatment for some of the things that we talked about, cancer, critical illnesses, those type of things. And it's very important. So we'll be right back. You're listening to The Real Money Coach Show.
Living in a world, confusion, trouble, trials and tribulations,
sorrow. If you don't know him, he's a wonderful God. Because you
didn't have to do it.
Thank you, Jesus.
But you did it. Didn't have to do it.
You've been so
good to me. Didn't have to do it.
But you did it.
But you did it.
Yeah. Hey, Grace family, join author Tony Jackson for the Real Money Coach broadcast each and every Saturday morning from 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9. Mr. Jackson enlightens you on the real secrets of money. He'll also help you increase, protect, and dominate your money. You can also catch Tony Jackson's The Real Money Coach every Tuesday at 8 p.m. on Facebook Live and YouTube. Check out The Real Money Coach, Mr. Tony Jackson, every Saturday morning, 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9.
Hey, Tony Jackson here. You know me as The Real Money Coach. Listen, I want to encourage you to do something. And what I want to encourage you to do is email me your questions, your comments, or even suggestions of topics that you'd like us to cover on The Real Money Coach Show. You can email it to info@therealmoneycoach.com. Again, that's info@therealmoneycoach.com. Email us your questions, your comments, your suggestions, and we will answer those on air and also on our Facebook Live YouTube show on Tuesdays at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. So make sure you email us so that we can get that information that you want to know in your ears. I am Tony Jackson, The Real Money Coach.
And welcome back to The Real Money Coach broadcast with author and host, Tony Jackson.
All right. Welcome back to the show here on Praise 100.9. This is The Real Money Coach Show, and I am your host, Tony Jackson. And I hope you enjoyed that interview with just a marvelous young lady, Jade Smith. I know her parents, her dad, her grandmother, and all her family is extremely proud of her. And so I'm really looking forward to her and Miss Shirley Smith, her grandmother, that will be on the show Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time on Facebook and YouTube, and just talking more about the fundraiser. Obviously, that's important. And then also, you know, the wonderful thing is that her grandmother is a cancer survivor. And so I think it's just important topic that we're dealing with today. Now, I want to talk a little bit about really, you know, why is this important? Why is raising funds important? I think we all have been, and as I shared in the first part of the segment, we've all been touched with cancer. I mean, I mentioned my father-in-law and his birthday, and eventually he also passed of cancer. But, you know, when I think about it and I look at some of the statistics as it relates to African-American people and cancer, I mean, it is having a tremendous impact on our lives. And, you know, when I was looking at the numbers from the National Cancer Institute, it estimates that, well, this is not an estimation. This is approximately, there were 224,000 new cancer cases in the United States among Black people in 2022. Let me tell you that number again. 224,000 new cases. 224,080 to be exact, 1,000 cases. Now, of those cases due to cancer, deaths among African-American, Black people in the U.S. only, there was 73,000 cancer deaths among African-American people in the United States. And so that's why, you know, research, that's why the fact that we are supporting something that will help us in this area. Now, the cancer deaths, especially among men, is only second to heart attacks, heart disease. And that actually is the same case with women. So heart disease is the number one. Cancer is number two. And so, you know, we got to realize that. Now, I want to share just a little bit in terms of when we think about the types of cancer and how it affects both men and women. And so of those cases with men in terms of new cancer cases in 2022, 41,000 of them, or 37%, were prostate cancer. 12%, or 13,000, were lung cancer, and then followed by colon and rectum cancer was the number three in terms of new cases for men. And in terms of death, the order is pretty much the same, except lung and cancer was the number one cause of death, then followed by prostate and then colon. When we look at African-American females, the number one by far and large was breast cancer, new cases, 36,000, 32%. And then lung cancer being number two at 12,000, and then colon cancer at number three at 10,000. And so it kind of really followed the same as men, except for when we get to the deaths, the leading death in terms of cancer causes was actually breast cancer for women, and then lung, and then colon cancer after that. And so the thing about it is, when you think about this, especially when we talk about prostate cancer and we talk about breast cancer for women, and we know that men can get breast cancer too. We understand that. But those are the two leading new cases of cancer, prostate for men and breasts for women. And the thing about it is, both of those are things that we have measures in place. Get your annual checkup, get your mammogram, women. Guys, you gotta let down the ego and get tested, get tested for the prostate and all those type of things. And then, of course, you know, everyone should be getting a colonoscopy and all these types of things so that we could prevent some of these things that we're happening, that's happening. Now, the other side of it, of course, and what I do is that, you know, we do offer life insurance. It's important. Especially now, because we have policies that have living benefits. And what living benefits do is it provides funding for critical illnesses, including cancer, heart attacks, these type of things, so that if you don't have insurance or you have copays, because treatments are expensive, if you have copays or if you have deductibles, or even just the cost of going and traveling for treatment, if you have to go out of town and some of these types of things. And the fact that, you know, of course, life still goes on. You still have your mortgage. You still have your car payment. You still have these other things that need to be done. But when you get a life insurance policy with the living benefits, like what we offer, it provides coverage for those things. It provides some payment, some financial resources if you want to seek alternative treatment, or if you simply need the money just to maintain your standard of living. So you should make sure that you have the new type of insurance rather than the old. And if you're not sure, just simply make an appointment with me. Just go to iPadAppointment.com. Let's make an appointment. Let's have a conversation. It's free. It doesn't cost you anything. So listen, that's our show for today. Thank you for joining us so much. Thank you again to Jade Smith for being with us, and we'll see you guys on Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern on Facebook and YouTube. This is the Real Money Coach Show. I got a call coming in, y'all. I gotta go. Take care.
We hope you've enjoyed the Real Money Coach broadcast with author and host Tony Jackson. We encourage you to utilize today's strategies and principles to manage your money in the most effective and winning way. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to send us an email, TonyJacksonAgency@gmail.com, or you can reach us on all social media platforms. And if you would like a copy of Tony Jackson's book, Increase, Protect, and Dominate Your Money, log on to www.therealmoneycoach.com. Until next week's empowering broadcast, God bless.